It's here. Conservation Halton has opened 5 of its parks to residents and visitors. CEO Hassan Bassett says they are excited to finally be open.
We're really happy to see people coming and visiting our parks. And so far, just for the weekend, we have 10,500 registrations. So that's 10,500 people are going to be visiting us. And, you know, it's an inventory that we watch and control based on the capacity that we feel will allow people to physically distance and still enjoy nature.
Conservation Halton has implemented a pre-registration system that is done on their website. Bassett says the process is simple.
It's all drop-down menus. You book the day you'd like to come, the time you'd like to come, because it is timed entry as well. And you book the number of people that are coming with you, you pay, and that's it. You get an e-ticket. You also enter your license plate number when you're registering. So all of that takes 2 minutes. When you arrive at the gate, our scanners will pick up your license plate and will let you in.
As Conservation Halton continues to utilize this pre-registration system from now until the foreseeable future, Bassett says depending on its success, this could be the new normal.
We're going to fine-tune it because we know we don't have it perfect right now. And we did a lot of pilots with our members leading up to today. So we had a lot of data, a lot of feedback, a lot of testing, and we felt comfortable that this will work really well. Is it going to be perfect? No. So the new normal will involve doing this type of pre-registration system. And the reason for that is, I think anybody who gets in their car, either by themselves or with their kids, or if they're seniors, and decides to go out to one of our conservation areas, they're coming here to access nature. They're not coming here to stand in lineups or fight for parking spots. So this is meant to truly make this experience great for everybody.
So, has it been great for everybody? Well, here's what some of you had to say.
Everyone seems to be following social distancing for the
most
part.
Yeah, even on the trails, like everyone like step back and like wait, at least keep the distance between.
Trails are wide enough for it.
Yeah.
I think it's great to have the opportunity to come out here and like just breathe in some fresh air and walk around those trails.
You know? Better than being cooped up inside.
I think it's actually really smart how the park is doing it, because I know that parks in the city, I'm from Toronto, there's a lot of people in them right now, and it was a little overwhelming. I didn't think that there'd be that many people there. So I think that this system of having the time slots is really smart, so that people just can feel safe and enjoy without worrying.
I feel like it's like fun being outside rather than just being inside doing all the boring stuff over and over again. Or like just being outside your house, and it's just so much more to do.
Yeah, you can like play lots of more games outside at Rattlesnake Point, and it just is super fun.
The 5 parks open include Crawford Lake, Hilton Falls, Mount Nemo, Kelso Summit, and here, Rattlesnake Point, with the rest to follow in the coming weeks. Reporting for Halton News, I'm Melissa Candelaria.